I have applied the common configurations to all hosts. Now I'm going to start applying the specific configuration, and I'm going to show an example of the frontend tier. Frontend is a Node.js application, and you see the playbook here, which should apply common configuration, Node.js, and then frontend. To run that Node application, you need Node.js to be installed. So I have a special playbook for that, and then I have a frontend playbook which does the application deployment. So it is going to pull an application from my Jenkins or some artifact server, and it creates, this is where it is actually creating some directories and paths where it should reside. And this is the variable frontend release URL. So frontend.release.url is the hierarchical variable frontend.release.url. That's what it is. And it's going to pull the artifact from that URL. That URL you can edit and update from the groupwares, and then it goes and creates a symlink. It creates defines a supervisor configuration. So supervisor is a process manager just like init, and it is a Python based sort of a process manager, I would say. And if you have a custom application, that's quite useful. This is the configuration for supervisor for running the front end application, so which command to invoke and from which directory. So we can provide all that configuration as part of that, and it is actually just copying that supervisor configuration from that SRC, that source, and then it will deploy and run it from, let's say, opt frontend, and it's running so node server.js, and then it starts that service with supervisor using that option or the last task here. This is the configuration. You'll see the command, the directory it runs from, and rest of the options, where to store the logs, etc., for that supervisor application. And in our example, so this frontend is going to run on port 80 on the host. So it runs on 8079, which gets mapped to 80. So I start running or refreshing my, I open a port 80 in my browser, and I don't see that application running right now. Later on, I should see that application once it has been deployed. Now the artifact, I need to pull it from Jenkins. I'm just going to verify that URL, copy that URL from Jenkins for the frontend package job. You might have a Jenkins file, and you might have created another job with Jenkins file. So just use whichever job you want to pull that application code or the artifact from, and get that URL. And that's the URL that you are going to feed in to your frontend release URL variable. So I copy the link address from here and go back to my Ansible code, the groupwares frontend, and this is where I have the URL. I'm going to replace this with the URL. Now the frontend and the Jenkins are part of the same Docker compose, so they can recognize each other with the host name that is Jenkins. So I'm going to replace this host with pure just Jenkins. I might have to do some additional configurations here on Jenkins, because Jenkins by default does not allow any of the artifacts to be downloaded by anonymous users. So if I go back and look at Jenkins configuration, so Jenkins manage Jenkins configuration, and then from manage Jenkins, if I select global security configuration, I see that the current authorization is locked in, user can do anything. I might have to change that later and use maybe a metrics-based security, but I'll show that to you later. First, I need to show you what is the problem. Now, I have the playbook for frontend, which is frontend.yaml. So I can apply that directly using Ansible playbook. But before I do that, it's always good to validate the connection. So using Ansible, name of the host, frontend, provide the inventory file if needed, and minus m ping. And this is the playbook, frontend.yaml. That's what I'm going to apply this time, using Ansible hyphen playbook, frontend.yaml. If I run syntax check, it shows everything is okay. I remove the syntax check option. If I run list task, it shows me that list of tasks that it is going to execute on the frontend. Some of those are part of common, some of those are part of Node.js. And then finally, the deployment call task from the frontend main.yaml. Our frontend's role, the task from frontend role, basically. So I'm going to start executing the frontend role, applying that using Ansible playbook options. So Ansible playbook frontend.yaml will just go ahead, connect to the frontend host. You also see the gathering fact. Gathering facts is where it is actually pulling the data from the host related to which operating system it is, which how much memory it is running, which architecture. So based on that, it can conditionally execute certain tasks as well. So all these common tasks have been run already, so it does not repeat that anymore, but it starts installing the nodejs. So it starts from that nodejs related configurations, and whatever is changed is what has, you know, been updated on this host at the time of executing this playbook. So it is installing nodejs, that's what I see, and it would start deploying the application as well by creating the directory structure, etc. And then it will try to pull the artifact, and that's where it actually failed here. It failed. If you look at the error, it says it failed because failure downloading the file, and it says 403 forbidden, and that's what I was talking about earlier. So what I need to do here is allow Jenkins to download the artifacts by anonymous users, and for that I would have to choose the metrics based security, where I say two types of users. One is authenticated users and anonymous users. Authenticated users, I want them to provide complete access, so I select all access. For anonymous, I just select read access from overall, and from the job section I choose read and workspace, so that it can read files from the workspace, and that's where our artifact is stored at. So I selected for anonymous users overall read access, and from job section read and workspace. For authenticated users, everything is okay. And this time around, if I run this again, this idempotent. So whatever was changed earlier, it is not going to take the same actions again. It would skip over those tasks and start with the task it failed from onwards. So let's give it some time to go over those previous tasks. And if you look at this, it's skipping most of these. It says okay for a lot of those tasks which are already in the desired state, and then it starts from downloading the release artifact, then it creates the directories, updates the supervisor deconfiguration, it also sends. So if you see that running handler is basically, if there is a change in the configuration, it asks the service to be restarted as well, and that's all automatic, which is fantastic, because otherwise you would have to update and go and restart the servers manually. It's not needed anymore because Ansible has a way to notify, and that notifier calls in handler. There's a handlers section, handlers directory, and then it goes and executes that. And if I go back and refresh my page, I see the front end has been deployed. Now, I didn't have to write a single line of code. I just had to provide the path to my artifact, and it automatically deployed it. It created everything on its own, and I can validate that by logging into the frontend server as well. So I run SSH DevOps at the rate frontend. The password is code spaces. And if I log in, I see that application running via supervisor D. So I see the Python supervisor D, and it's calling the script to run frontend, which is a node application. So I see that node server.js. And if I browse to opt directory, I see a frontend, which is the symlink, which is part of my deployment code. And that points to opt apps frontend releases. And here you can add any number of releases and then point to the latest release and restart the service to deploy a new version of this frontend application.